So, hello students, we will continue with the rest of the problems. Already two problems we have done under regression lines. Now next problem is, see, if 8x minus 10y plus 66 equal to 0 and 40x minus 18y equal to 214 are the two regression lines. Regression lines are given. Find the mean and mean of x and y and the correlation coefficient. Find also sigma y. They have given sigma y if sigma x equal to 3. So the two regression lines already given, they have not given the table to calculate correlation coefficient. Please make a note of it. Okay, they have given the two regression lines. So the regression line passes through, as I told you in the last recording, definitely the regression line passes through the mean of x and y. So we can replace these two regression lines by their mean. X will replace by x bar, y we will replace by y bar. We will get two equations. Solve these two equations using your calculator. Two unknowns, right? So substitute in your calculator, you will get the two unknowns, x bar and y bar. So values will be 13 and 17. So mean x and mean y, we got the value. Next, we need to find the correlation coefficient. To calculate the correlation coefficient, we need the formula r equal to plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y. Now how to get that? See, what are the regression lines? I'll write the first regression line. Okay, what is the first regression line? I'll write, instead of minus 10y, I'll bring this side. I'll get what? 10y equal to 8x plus 66. But always the regression line should be in which form? You remember in the note I told you, what about the regression line? It is in which form? Is it y minus y bar? Correct now? So y minus y bar equal to something into x minus x bar. Here this is called as what? Coefficient of x. And this is called as coefficient of y. So always the regression line should be under this form. Then only we can write coefficient of x and coefficient of y. So what we will do is, here I'll write y in terms of, see, here I'll write y. 10y I brought this side. So 10y equal 8x plus 66. So y will be 0.8x plus 6.6. Similarly, the x value, I'll write minus 18y. I bring this side. I'll get 40x equal that. So x equal to this. So we got y equal to this. We get x equal to this. But we need for y minus y bar form, correct? Since this is a regression line, definitely mean will pass us through this line. So what we can write? Can we write y bar equal to 0.8 x bar plus 6.6, correct now? Then subtract this. So what you get? Y minus y bar equal to 0.8 x minus x bar plus 6.6 minus 6.6 cancels. So ultimately what you get here? Y minus y bar is equal to 0.8 into x minus x bar. So what is our regression coefficient of x? That is 0.8. So in other words, whenever you get this kind of equation, directly you can say, what is the regression coefficient of x? It is 0.8. Similarly, see here, what is x? X we got 0.45y plus 5.3y. But actually, what is coefficient of y? How to get it? It should satisfy mean also, right? So what we can write, x bar equal to 0.45 y bar plus 5.35. So if we subtract x minus x bar equal to 0.45 y minus 0.45 y bar, then 5.35 minus 5.35 cancels. So what you get ultimately here, x minus x bar equal to 0.45 into y minus y bar. So what is the coefficient of y? Is it 0.45? Correct, ma'am. So directly we can notice here, but actually that is the way to get, okay, coefficient of x, coefficient of y. But always remember, whenever you get in this form, y equal to something into x plus 6.6, that is, what is the meaning of coefficient of x? 0.8. And what is the meaning of coefficient of y? 0.45. Actually, how to get it? So you need to substitute y bar, x bar, subtract these two, that time you will get coefficient of x. Here also similarly, that time you will get coefficient of y. But by making like this, no, we can make out, right, what is the coefficient of x? That is 0.8. No need to do all those things, just to write what is the coefficient of x, 0.8. what is the coefficient of y, 0.45. but be careful, it should be y equal to, and here it should be x equal to. Okay, so when you multiply, you will get plus or minus square root of 0.36, that is plus or minus 0.6. But coefficient of x and coefficient of x both are positive, so we can take coefficient of correlation as plus 0.6. Now, already one more thing they have given, sigma x equal to 3. What we know regarding this? We know this expression, right? R into sigma y by sigma x is equal to for coefficient of correlation. But what is coefficient of correlation? We got the answer here, correct? We got the answer they have given, right? So sigma x r what we got? 0.8 r into sigma y by sigma x. We can take this anyone, correct? Na? So because when we subtract, what you get actually y bar equal to 0.8 x bar, correct? Na? When you subtract y minus y bar, 0.8 into x minus x bar. So what is r sigma y by sigma x? That is nothing but 0.8. Okay, understood? 0.8. So that gives you sigma y value 4. Now next, compute x bar, y bar and r from the equation of the regression line. Again, regression lines are given. So regression line passes through the mean of x and mean of y. So replace x and y by x bar, y bar. So write down the equations properly. Substitute in your calculator, you will get x bar value, y bar value. Now, what will be the regression lines? We will write it properly now. So, 3y, I'll write plus 1, I'll bring this side, plus 2x, I'll bring this side. You will get y equal to minus 2 by 3x minus 1 by 3. Similarly, I'll do it here. These two, I'll take to the other side. You will get x equal to minus 6y plus 4. Now, coefficient of correlation, how to write coefficient of correlation? R we need plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y. So, what is coefficient of x here? I told you how to get it actually y bar minus 2 by 3 x bar. When you subtract, what is the coefficient of x? Minus 2 by 3. What is the coefficient of y? Minus 6. Both are negative. So, when you simplify, you will get plus or minus 2. If both are negative, what answer you need to take? R equal to minus 2. But is this possible? It is not possible. Why? Because coefficient of correlation is always in between what I have given in the note. It should be in between minus 1 and plus 1. Okay, so this exceeds that minus 2. So we cannot take the regression lines this way. Okay, if we take this way, we will get coefficient of correlation as r equal to minus 2. So this is not possible. Writing this way. So what we need to do, so here we have taken the line as 3y equal to that side and here x equal to that. Now we will do in another way. So we will take 2x this side and rest to the other side. That time what you will get, 2x equal to minus 3y minus 1. Then x will be minus 3 by 2y minus 1 by. Similarly, I'll keep here y only, rest of the term that side. So what you get, y is equal to 1 by 6x minus 4 by 6, that is 2 by 3. Now, can you calculate coefficient of correlation? R equal to plus or minus square root of coefficient of x into coefficient of y. What is coefficient of x? 1 by 6. What is coefficient of y? Minus 3 by 2. So, what is the answer? You have 3 ones or 3 twos are minus 1 by 4 you will get. That is plus or minus 1 by 2. Okay. So, now don't see the sign here. Just we need to write which side, plus sign or minus sign, depending upon the coefficient. See here, one is positive, another one is negative. So what you need to write coefficient of correlation as r equal to plus half. If both are negative, then only you need to write coefficient of correlation as negative. In all other cases, you need to write r equal to plus half. So what is the answer here? R equal to plus half. So remember this, whenever the regression lines are given and if you are writing by your own, if you write 2x equal to something and here 6y equal to something, if you don't get here, if you write 3y equal to this, x equal to, if you get coefficient of correlation exceeds this limit, then we need to write regression line in another way. I have written in another way and then you need to calculate the coefficient of correlation. That time you see what answer you will get. You will get plus or minus 1 by 2. And depending upon the coefficient sign. If both are negative, then you need to take negative value. If one is positive, another one is negative, or both are positive, what is the answer? You need to write coefficient of correlation as plus half. Thank you.